Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. I want to appreciate you so much because of your great support. Please consider subscribing to this channel. Jubilee drama as Sabina Chege now wants to meet Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta after tribunal blow out, or rather strike out, the agenda of taking Jubilee party. This is the statement of Sabina Chege. I want to ask our former party leader, that is how he's calling Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. I want to ask our former party leader, let him call us together as his children so that we can resolve these issues. Just 4 days ago, the faction was dealt a blow after the political party's tribunal barred them from running the party affairs of the Jubilee Party. The camp of Sabina Chege, Kanini Kega, was also barred from calling an annual general meeting or issuing any communication on the party until petition is determined. Nominated Member of Parliament through Jubilee Party was appointed as the interim party leader on May 2nd this year, said her camp is not after fighting anybody and that they are only opposed to joining protest organized by the Azimio la Umoja coalition. Now, after the blow from the tribunal, Sabina Chege has urged former President Uhuru Kenyatta to hold a meeting with party members to iron out Jubilee Party issues. As these people have already identified that things are not going good on their side, they are realizing that this battle is out of their hands. They were used, but those few individuals that were busy and having momentum towards ensuring the Jubilee Party was not going to be led by Jeremiah Kioni, Uhuru Kenyatta, David Murathe, and their team. Rather, what they wanted was that Sabina Chege to be the party leader, Kanini Kega to be the secretary general, with other new appointed leaders by the camp of Sabina Chege and Kanini Kega. But in the news that we received that the camp was also barred from calling an annual general meeting or issuing any communication on the party until petition is determined, is that Sabina Chege said that their aim is to ensure that they are going to unite themselves, both their team and the team of Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta, to ensure that they are going to ensure that this party leadership and wrangles is going to be resolved once and for all. This is the statement. Our main aim is to ensure the party does not die. We failed in the Juja and Kiamba by-election in 2021 and got fewer positions in 2022 elections. That is the trend we want to stem. We don't want to continue losing. Now, she's promising that they are not fighting anyone. What she's saying, that they will not, or they are disagreeing with the kind of demonstrations of Raila Amolo Odinga's team, I don't know how this connects with the growth of the party, because you can decide not to participate in a Azimio demonstration, but still you are part and parcel, membership of Azimio is still intact. We had already knew what was happening in between, because this was not a fight of Sabina Chege Kanini Kega and their camp. This was a fight of Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta and William Samoei Ruto Rigathi Gachagua. As the camp came out frustrating, blackmailing Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta, and their main aim was to ensure that Uhuru Kenyatta is not going to rise in any part and political nature in Mount Kenya region through his political party. So these people are showing a kind of panicking and afraid of whatever might happen if they are going to leave Jubilee Party alone. So last term, Sabina Chege said that the party had 177 MPs, with the number reducing to only 28 this term. But again, when it comes to their concern, the former ruling party was ranked third. I think after, if I'm not wrong, after UDA, ODM, then I think Jubilee Party. But I want you to understand something that is very crucial. As much as we can see it just the way it is scanty outside, but deeply inside it, we do understand who are these people behind pushing Sabina Chege and Kanini Kega to go after the Jubilee Party. I remember it just about 5 months like that, where there were some messages leaked in between, where there was a conversation between Sabina Chege, Kanini Kega, Aiden Keinan, Kutuny, and the so-called the chairperson of Jubilee Party under the camp of Kanini Kega. They were so worried towards the fight they were portraying to take over the Jubilee Party leadership. Even they realized that this was going to paint a bad picture of their political career in the Mount Kenya region. So what they're being portrayed to do to ensure that Jubilee Party is going to divide it, and they're going to ensure that they're going to fold Jubilee Party. In a matter of fact, these people have realized that this is not a fight that is going to build us politically, but there's a possibility of destroying us politically in Mount Kenya region. So for them, after realizing that is why Sabina Chege is responding and requesting Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta to sit down with his team to ensure that their issues are going to be resolved once and for all. But again, is there any possibility of these people resolving? Because I asked you a simple question the other time, that what if the petition that is being heard by the party tribunal is going to decide that now the Jubilee Party is legally owned by the leadership of Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta, Jeremiah Kioni, David Murathe, and others? There's a certain scenario that this Sabina Chege and her team might not like when it comes to the political of Jubilee. Because now, it is a fight of Jubilee Party, yes. Sabina Chege was nominated. Remember, she's afraid of losing her seat as nominated member of parliament. So her fight is, in any case, she was going to be the party leader. Things were going to be easier. But in any case, Jubilee Party is going to be given fully the leadership of Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. Mark my words, Sabina Chege is going to be removed as nominated member of parliament, because it was Jubilee Party who submitted the name of Sabina Chege to be nominated as member of parliament in National Assembly. So if this is going to happen, Sabina Chege is afraid of losing her seat. Today, they were in Murang'a together with Moses Kuria distributing food to their people. I realized that she's trying to bring back the momentum of our politics. And I read her timeline in Facebook. I realized that she's revamping herself, coming back in politics of Murang'a. So as much as we are concerned, even requesting Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta to call them so that they can resolve their issues. It is a matter of time and whatever is going to happen in between them, because we don't believe that this team of Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta will accept to accommodate the Sabina Chege and Jeremiah Kion. No trust at all. There will be no trust. So what I believe in, despite of Sabina Chege calling for Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta to call them and unite them, who is going to lead the Jubilee Party? Because they tried to hook up and to squander a kind of the process and progress of Jubilee Party that was on place, to make Jubilee Party as a shell party, a party that has wrangles all over the country. Ladies and gentlemen, what are thoughts? Drop your opinion at the comment section below. I want to appreciate you so much because of your support. Please consider subscribing, liking, commenting, and sharing this video. Bye bye till you meet on another video.